CSR has some pretty lofty goals to take away 20% of our energy usage by 2030. This project kind of formed a part of that on how we could reduce our electricity usage.
We were successful in getting the funding from the New South Wales government to improve our compressed air usage. This funding involved a survey.
It's pretty normal for sites to buy a compressor, and when they're running out of compressed air, they buy another compressor and just add it into the system, and that cycle continues. Very, very common to see compressors that are too large, too big, too inefficient fitted to a system.
What I would say is it seems at first that it's quite expensive to get the guys out and do all the testing, and you kind of think, oh, could we just kind of manage it ourselves? But one thing I found is that because we got a really solid report through, then we had the option to either do it ourselves or to actually try and do it all in one hit. And we chose the option to do it all in one hit because we had such good data to know where all our leaks were. We could just attack it in one go. That really kind of put the problem to bed and move on to the next thing.
So here at Cemintel, we have two compressors. We have a 132, which is a non-VSD machine. And then we've got a 180 kilowatt, which is a VSD. In between the two compressors, we've got a ring main system. So what we do is we basically monitor the pressure between the two compressors. Before the actual project, we needed to use both compressors to actually support the plant. But once the leaks were fixed, the repairs were done, we are now able to run on one compressor most of the time. If we can turn one compressor off, we are looking at around $100,000 a year in savings.
We identified the potential for them to save $83,000 in energy. Part of that was in the way the compressors were set up. What we discovered when we were measuring the system is that the VSD compressor was set up as the base load compressor, and they were using the fixed speed as the trimming compressor. By fixing the controls on the two compressors, we were able to reverse that situation, and just that alone was able to save them approximately $30,000. When we did the leakage audit, we identified it a further $53,000 worth of leakage. That required a bit of extra planning because you need to order parts and organise the labour and coordinate with the site to shut the system down, but we were able to fix those leaks in one day.
We've hit our year one targets. We're actually at our year three targets at this point. So that's really helpful then. It kind of means that we can focus on some of the other projects then and deliver further down the road.